Today is Sunday, March 28th, 2021. I am in the Angeles National Forest today, in the Big Pines area, right here. This is Big Pines Highway N-4 that goes from Big Pines Junction with Angeles Crest down to the high desert. So I'm about at an elevation of just under 6,800 feet. I'm not that far from the junction of Angeles Crest. I'm at this little place called Arch Picnic Area. Never actually stopped off over here before. I'm not planning any big peak climbs today. I'm just planning on having a mellow, relaxing day up here in the mountains. Just want to be around some big trees today. And big pines is a place to see big trees. Especially when you go over towards the base of that ridge over there. That's where you start seeing some really, really tall pines and firs. So this is the Arch Picnic area. Never actually stopped off over here per se. It's like a really nice area. So let's see what we got down here. Gosh, it smells good to be in the pines and firs again. Now, last week I didn't, it's muddy over here. Last week I didn't have any adventure videos, so I didn't go out on any hikes last week. I was basically, just kind of lazy. Now, the sad thing is, the weather last weekend was absolutely phenomenal. Where I live, it was only around 68, 70 degrees in Orange County. Whereas today, it's supposed to be about 90 degrees where I live. Up here, it's supposed to actually be, I think, in the mid-60s, so very warm for this time of year. But yeah, I see why I want to come over here. See, we're at the base of that ridge I was talking about, and the trees start getting much larger. So I love north-facing slopes. So, yeah, this month here in Southern California, weather's been, actually for the most part, this month has actually been cooler than normal. Drier than normal, but cooler than normal up until about yesterday. Yesterday was already up in the 80s where I live. Today, in the 90s. All next week's supposed to be hot. I was looking at the extended outlooks, though. It's supposed to cool down just before Easter. It's very muddy over here. Whew. Just trying to see what kind of cool stuff I can find around here. There's a lot of cool stuff, that's for sure. Look at some of these cones. Trying to see if we got ponderosas or Jeffries here. Yeah, last week also didn't really do anything either, other than I got my first round of vaccination, first COVID shot. So have that in another 3 more weeks. It's like 4 weeks between shots since I had the Moderna. Down here by the gooseberries and currants. These look like Sierra currants. Ribes nevadensis. Or nevadense, I should say. Nevadense. And this is one of the neatest parts of Angeles National Forest. Because we also have black oak around here too, Quercus kelloggii. So the eastern part of Angeles National Forest is where you can get those beautiful black oaks. You can see the leaves on the ground. It's way too early for them to start leafing out. And yeah, beautiful white fir here. And I think this year, I think I might redo my spotlight on white firs here in Southern California, because I labeled them as obvious conchylor variety. Conchylor, the Rocky Mountain variety, because according to Michael Kaufman's Conifers of the Pacific Slope, the ones from the Tehachapis down here in the Southern California and Northern Baja, he labels them as variety conchylor, separate from the variety Lowiana in the Sierras in Northern California. But just about all the others, just about all the other sources label ours here in, from the Tehachapis down into Baja is also Lowiana, so just, I don't know. That's why, you know, taxonomy can be quite an interesting thing to consider. Regardless of what variety they really are, they are awesome trees. Beautiful spot over here. Very peaceful. This would be actually a good picnic area. Just coming here after the snow melts, it's very muddy over here, so be aware. I was thinking about maybe doing some hiking on this side here, but I don't have micro spikes with me, and I'm pretty sure that snow is icy. We even got wild rose here. Obviously, it hasn't leaf greened up yet. It's a little too early right now. But yeah, this side's more covered in snow, because this is more of a north-facing slope. So today's going to be kind of like a drive to a spot, get some video, maybe drive to another spot, get some more video. Fortunately, next week, my schedule's not going to allow me to really get out and do much next week. It's my, got split days off again next week, so doesn't look like there's going to be much coming up next week either. Then the following week, I have a few extra days off that I requested so I can maybe do something a little more extensive. I love these little adventures, but also kind of want to start getting back into more significant hiking like I used to do, especially before this coronavirus stuff came through. There's a lot of noisy kids. I don't know if I'm going to linger too long here, because I kind of, you know, I'm still doing the social distancing thing. Well, muddy, but it's not as loose as it would be if it were dry. Yeah, we've got a nice little thicket of white firs here. Kind of neat looking, actually. Yeah, they're all just growing together here. I'm near sure these are separate trees. Well, this one little sapling didn't make it very far. This one's doing pretty well. This little guy here doing okay. This one here didn't make it. That one's kind of stunted. This is really deep in the shade here. Maybe one of these, well, these trees are not very old either, so they might be here for quite a while, so the other tree might be kind of growing slowly for a while. It's pretty good, a little trickling creek over here. Oh, looks like we got, I think we got Western Chokecherry over here. I think that's what that is. Did a spotlight on Western Chokecherry here in the Angeles last August when it was fully leafed out. Wow, that's a big white fir. Nice. It's not super tall, but it's got a very nice girthy trunk to it. Beautiful tree. Wow. Beautiful. Actually, girthier white trunks I've seen here in Angeles National Forest. Not nearly as tall, but it's just about as girthy as that 180 plus footer near Buckhorn Campground on Angeles Crest Highway. But it's not quite as tall though. It's also a big girthy one behind Grassy Hollow Visitor Center too. It's about as girthy as this one. It's got a huge trunk. Gorgeous tree. I guess until I really feel confident again in what white fir we have, I might just go back to referring to it as just obvious conchalor. I guess you could say I'm a taxonomy nut. Oh, sugar pine sapling. See if I can maybe find a more secluded spot. Yeah, that Big Pine Visitor Center right over there, just over the hill. There's a white fir I was just visiting. Big trunk. Here's the top of it there. It's probably only about 120 feet tall. The other one's much, much taller than that, but the trunks are kind of similar in size. So here's a more arid side here, the more sun-baked side, where it's mostly Jeffrey pine and canyon live oak and black oak. This side here, more north facing slopes here, just chock full of nice sized trees. Of course, you get closer up there and start seeing more sugar pines. Some of the sugar pines in the Big Pines area are quite impressive in size. but as for here in Southern California, the largest sugar pines I've seen have been basically by have been by some along Keller Peak Road in the San Bernardino National Forest. I would say definitely the San Bernardino Mountains have some of the larger sugar pines. I've seen some pretty big ones in the San Jacinto Mountains, and some of the most impressive ones I've ever seen still are the ones on Pine Mountain in Ventura County, where near Reyes Peak and Haddock Mountain, along the Reyes Peak Trail and the Pine Mountain Service Road that leads up to the campgrounds. There are some really, really big sugar pines over there. Actually, it's one of the prettiest areas I've ever hiked. Hiked up to Reyes Peak and Haddock Mountain. That was before I started filming my hikes. I started filming them, but I didn't start uploading them yet. And I didn't shoot video that day, unfortunately. Like a dummy. Well, this will probably do it for this video. I'm just going to go down Big Pines Highway to a couple other spots, maybe see some other Forest Service roads or something. Maybe I can see if I can find some, I don't know, just find some big trees. I'm kind of in the mood to see some really tall trees today. So, we'll go see how that goes. I guess I'll see you on my next video. Thanks for watching.